consider subscribing to my dinky little channel here. This was information that was very hard won on my end. Please, please subscribe. Okay, so I'm going to attempt to just film this here in my little apartment in Nansum. It's Friday night, kind of a quiet evening, which was by request for me. It's what I wanted, just a little tired and resting. We got lots of fun stuff lined up for the weekend, and I want to get a good start tomorrow morning. I've been promising for a while to do a follow-up video on flirting in Thailand, and my girlfriend here was just shooting some stuff for a video on the Mu Phoi, but she's still here just shredding that pork. I'm looking down. She's sitting on the floor. She's hard at it. Bless her little heart. Getting hungry thinking about it. So Bing Ping. So that's eye contact in a flirtatious way. Again, there's no one rule on anything in life, obviously. So it's a general rule, Thais, you know, Thai people will not make much eye contact with you. Except I have to say, I get some. Some of it's flirting. Some of it's they're just super curious. Today I was at the local store buying some things, and some of the people were repeating back phrases I said. I would say something. Oh, what was it? Pepsi, my sai nam dan. That's a diet Pepsi. And they go, yeah, Pepsi, my sai nam dan. They repeat it back. They're just, Fawn's looking at me like, really? I mean, they're just fascinated with us. If you're living really immersed, like I'm, you can see my nunchuck and my Rambo knife in the background, nunchucks and my Rambo knife. I got that through airport security, believe it or not. I just thought, in the lark, I'll take it because I have a big knife collection back home, and I couldn't leave it all with my son. It'd be too much for his apartment. So anyways, here we are. So they're making some eye contact, not flirtatious, maybe with the one lady a little bit, but, you know, can't blame her, right? Can't blame her. You'll get some, if you're in a big city and getting eye contact, highly likely that's a flirt, okay? But if you're more immersed out in the country like I am, then it could be curiosity, and you'll have to sort that out. But God, I wish I could have had recorded a couple of them. There's some really good ones. I mean, you'll generally, your gut will kind of tell you, hey, that's that lady's interested in me. But if they look dead at you, okay, and it's almost like a pleading, kind of like, please come talk to me, because they're very shy and they're just so fearful of rejection, which would be losing face. And then the Thai culture, saving face, maintaining face, is really like almost of paramount importance. They don't want to give that up. So for them to really overtly flirt would be just like, I'm saying, it's like dropping their panties and throwing them at you. I mean, that would really be a very bold move. Remember, in Thailand, no PDA, no public display of affection. Married couples typically don't even kiss in private. Kissing is not a big thing here. Just, we like it, but the Thais don't really kiss. That's too personal to them. It's so weird. The real culture is so backwards from what we all think of from like Bangkok, right? Anyway, so, but they all will accommodate their full-on boyfriends. Trust me on that. So, having said all that, if a lady makes eye contact with you for 1, 2, 3 seconds, okay, 2, 3 seconds, that's a lot of eye contact. If she has kind of a really looking at you, you know, if she wobbles her head a little tiny bit, or lifts an eyebrow, or makes a little nod, or and obviously a smile. She's smiling with it, okay? That's a bing ping, and that's an that's a flirt to you, and that's an opening for you to please come and flirt, because it would be very rare for the lady to take a step further than that. You'll miss all these opportunities. So when that happens, okay, now what do you do? Okay, so the first thing you do is smile. Remember, calm, slow movements. No, you know, don't do that. You'll scare them off. You'll embarrass them. they'll be more afraid of losing face. Now, don't do that. Just all movement should be slow and small, not big, and very deliberate. And all you have to do is smile and, you know, nod a little bit. And they don't care if you're smooth or not. They don't care. They don't care. That's not important to them. What's important to them is that when they want a full-on boyfriend, they want a guy that's solid. Yeah, not just financially. We bring a lot of stability to things if you think about our culture. And the Thai men are infamous for not providing that kind of stability. They have all kinds of kids, all kinds of ladies, and they run off. Not all of them. You can't say that about any group of people. But that's happened to the ladies that are interested in you or their friends. And now they're interested in you. Okay? So you do that, and if you smile back and you know, make eye contact back, and she's you can tell if she's receptive, you're green light, buddy. You're green light. You get your phone, and you'll already, as I've told you before, you'll have WhatsApp or Line, Messenger on Facebook. Chai Mai Messenger, yeah. Ekali, anything more? WhatsApp, Line, Messenger.
Instagram, Tinder.
Oh, Instagram or Tinder. Okay. You know an awful lot about this. I'm kidding. Those are the kinds of things. And then you can exchange information through your phone. Again, my favorite communication tool is Line. It's known to be very secure. It's a little harder to load on your phone than WhatsApp. If you're not a phone guy at all, then just get the WhatsApp. It's fine. But Line is bigger here. I will take that back. Line is bigger here. But also Facebook is giant. And so, but with Facebook Messenger, you're giving up your ID a little bit. And I don't like that as much. So I would still, Line is my first choice. WhatsApp's my second choice. And everything else goes after that.
Thai lady use Line.
Hmm?
Thai lady use Line the most.
Yeah, Line is the big one. She's saying that. So you can get the add a person thing, and you can have it where you either show the reader, or you know, show the barcode, or read the barcode. I think it's better to have it on read, because they have to show their, you know, they have to show their barcode, and I think you're better off. It's like getting her number. It's like the old, you know, back in the 70s when I used to do this for real, I would get her number. And this is the same thing, and only it's way better. So do that, and then you can just say, you know, thank you. By then you'll have learned on my channel that, you know, sawadee kap. End of the first half.